Hello, everyone. My name is Pasada, and I'm a bhikkhuni from Dhammasara Monastery. So we are here today to celebrate Ajahn Brahm's 70th birthday, and hoping to do some metta meditation to share some good wishes and good energy to Ajahn Brahm. So that's very good intention, and very kind of all of you to come here to do that for Ajahn Brahm. So the first time I came across Ajahn Brahm was years ago, and I was looking for a retreat to do. And we had this Buddhist magazine with lots of advertising for retreats, any kind of retreats. And I was flicking through this magazine, and I saw Ajahn Brahm's picture with this big, nice smile. And underneath that it says, a humorous monk from the Ajahn Chah tradition. I had no idea who is Ajahn Chah, but I thought to myself, that smile is very nice, and humorous is good, so I'll go to his retreat. So that's something always very special about Ajahn Brahm, that his joy and that kind of welcoming. Now you see his photo, he's just so welcoming, yeah? And that's precisely the quality of metta. So metta is this attitude in the mind, this quality in the heart, that welcome. That welcomes what's in front of you. And in the suttas, metta is always described as very, very wide, very open, very boundless. It's never kind of like loving feeling for this group of people, but not you. Yeah. That's not metta, because you love this part, then the other part, then you hate. So metta is always very, very open. It's always talked about for all beings. Have that sense of openness and acceptance. And that's something that, to me, Ajahn Brahm is someone who has developed metta to a very high level. And especially for me, as a bhikkhuni, his openness to help bhikkhunis, yeah, that is really supportive in helping women. That's half the population, and not just women, but he supports homosexuals, anyone who the society thinks we can do without you. Something wrong with you. You're not as good. And Ajahn Brahm is one of those people that really happy to stand up and support and always give them a chance. So to me, that's just so touching. The sense of integrity of his practice and the level that he has developed, the kindness that it shows, and the maturity of his own spiritual development. So that's all the qualities that I'm sure many people appreciate, and that's why we all come here to celebrate his birthday. He has plenty of metta, but like I'm sure he'll be very happy to know that everyone come here to do more metta, And to practice as a group, we support each other. And the energy support each other. And just having a group of people having the same intention is something very, very powerful. There's something important in terms of action. So that's very praiseworthy. So for metta meditation, we try to cultivate this attitude of mind to have the same kind of openness, have the kind of acceptance. And the manifestation of real metta is always this kind of like tenderness in the heart and softens the mind and it heals. Yeah, that's the quality of metta. So then something that Ajahn Brahm taught about metta that I always find very useful and very important. And he said, if it's really metta, precisely it has the quality of healing. It softens. So if you try it on your body first and find a part of the body that you don't feel comfortable, and see if you can bring it to mind and relate to it with a mind full of metta, then that coarseness in the body should subside. Yeah? So then he said, well, then you have a very tangible way to know for yourself what is actually metta. Because not every loving feeling is metta. There's many kind of romantic love. That kind of feeling is pleasant feeling. It's loving feeling, but it's not necessarily metta. So I'm sure I heard the program for everyone doing this week of metta meditation. So it's just you just do a lot of meditation on metta. So I expect all of the audience is all experts by now. So then we'll try see if we can apply what Ajahn Brahm taught. Yeah. So the more traditional way of practice, well, traditional, as in the Visuddhimagga way of practicing metta, is very common that you bring four persons into your mind. Okay. So typically is yourself, a person that you have a friendly relationship with, and a neutral person, and then a more difficult person. Okay. For the purpose of this particular session, you can choose, you're welcome to choose anyone. But maybe if you're more of a beginner, maybe you choose someone that's easier to have a sense of care and friendliness towards, someone that you already have a friendly feeling towards. Yeah? But if you're already very advanced, then you're welcome to choose someone that maybe you feel a little bit more difficult, that's fine. You're also welcome to choose animals, teddy bears, what else? A plant? Anything really. Something that you find easy to develop metta towards. So I guess we'll start the meditation. Yeah? And if you can find a comfortable position for you. For metta meditation, it's very important, especially metta meditation, it's very important that your body is comfortable. You don't want to be pain here, pain there, and then you struggle with the back, and then at the same time you're like metta. That's you have to have kind feeling towards your body first. Okay. So you can sit down on the floor if you want to. You can sit on a chair if you want to. You can do a headstand if you want to. You can stand on one leg if you want to. Whatever is comfortable for you. Yeah. But it's better to have a position that you can be alert, awake. So lying down, if you can do it without falling asleep, that's also okay. So find a comfortable position, and you may want to close your eyes and relax your body. So check that your body is comfortable. And if you notice any discomfort in your legs or your back, then feel free to move to a more comfortable position. And make sure your neck and shoulder relax and at ease. And then your face is also relaxed. And without a sense of rushing ahead to do anything, just stay in the present for now, not doing anything. Have all the time in the world. Because when you're present, there's no time. Notice what it feels like to sit here. And if you notice a certain part of the body that is coarser, or even pain, then you can become aware of that part of the body. And see if you can welcome it. See if you can open your heart to it and make friends with it. As it is, not trying to change it. Not trying to fix it. In fact, you are respecting it. You are respecting it as it is. It has its own value. Just like being a friend, you don't need to control your friend. All you need to do as a friend is to be very present. Pay attention and listen. And most of all, you don't bring labels and memories from the past and stick it onto the person in front of you. Labels like, you hurt me before. You caused me pain before. I know what you're like. You're this label that I put on you. So the mind with metta is very present. Doesn't even have any labels from the past. Any thought that draw boundaries between you and the other person, all those you let go of. And just be open. Welcoming. Friendly. And respectful. and very present. And notice that as you arouse the attitude of metta in your mind, it is real metta. There will be a tender feeling in your heart. And a part of the body that you have been looking at. Should soften just a little bit. So once you recognize this quality of metta in your heart, you can either choose another part of your body to do the same thing, it should be a short hop over, so you do metta towards yourself. Or to whoever you want to do metta for, they're suitable for this, for your stage of meditation right now. And like I said, you can also use an object or animals. So find a suitable object of attention. See if you can apply the same quality of mind towards this person. So if you're thinking of this yourself that you do metta for, then you welcome yourself as who you are. Not try to change yourself in any way. And respecting and valuing wherever you are in your development as an individual, and just caring, just be there. listening. So I'll be silent for another 20 to 30 minutes or so. you may want to notice. A very tender feeling in your heart. And a mind that opens all the boundaries, opens all the walls and armors that you have built out of fear, out of aversion. And notice that you have opened some of those doors and just become lighter, softer. And because your heart is more open, and because your heart is wider, then you can invite others to come and join you in this sense of goodness in your heart, friendliness in your heart. You can share this feeling of metta and all the wholesome qualities in your mind that you have developed with all of our Dhamma teachers in our life so far. And our Dhamma friends. And especially think about Ajahn Brahm. Including him in this golden light and brightness. With all the wholesome qualities in your mind. And thanking him. For teaching us the Dhamma. And if you're sitting in a group, then notice that you won't just feel your own energy. You feel that everyone in the room is also the same. Their heart is also more open, friendlier, have more wholesome qualities in their hearts. And they too, making the same wish for all those people who have helped them on their Dhamma journey. And you can feel the quality of that energy as you're sitting here. And you may also want to wish Ajahn Brahm for good health, despite all the fish and chips he eats. And wish that he reaches various spiritual development in this very life, if he's not there already. I wish that he can share the Dhamma with many more people in this world. And finally, we want to share the merits of our practice. With our parents, family and good friends, all of our Dhamma teachers, Dhamma friends, and to Ajahn Brahm, and ultimately for all beings. May all beings be well. May all beings be benefited by the noble Dhamma and cultivate good actions. And may all beings find peace and liberation and happiness in their lives. So have your mind coming back to your body. Noticing you're sitting here. And have a reflection of what is your mind right now and how did you get here? How did you use your mind? And remember it for your next meditation. Whatever that benefits you. So after taking 3 deep breathing, I invite you to slowly open your eyes and come out of meditation.